following steps will guide you through the process of creating a Roku channel with a grid layout. In order to speed up the channel build, we will use the default MRSS feed for each of the several grid rows. The MRSS feed contains example video stream URLs, poster URLs, and other details required for each video in a grid row. We'll also use one standard grid row which can contain one or more individual videos. If you would like to use your own video streams and poster images, you can substitute your own URLs in the video item contained in the standard grid row, or you can add new video items to the standard grid row. The prerequisites are a free Instant TV channel account, which can be found at www.instanttvchannel.com, a free Roku developer account, which can be found at developer.roku.com, a Roku device connected to a TV set or computer monitor, or a TV set with a built-in Roku device. Here are the step-by-step directions. Log into your Instant TV channel account. From the menu along the left side of the page, select Channels. Click the New Channel button at the bottom of the channel list. Select the channel type of Scene Graph and then click the Confirm button. Your new Roku channel is at the bottom of your channel list and should be highlighted in yellow. From the menu along the left side of the page, select Theme. This is the Theme Editor. It allows you to change the look and feel of your Roku channel. We'll be changing several different things here. In the title box at the top of the list, change My Channel to the name you want your new channel to have, for example, Grid Demo. Scroll down to the Background Image parameter and enter http://ex.irchan.com/grid/background.jpg. The Background Image parameter changes the springboard background from this to this. Scroll down to the Grid Background Poster Opacity parameter and change it from 0 to 30. If the Grid Background Poster Opacity parameter is 0, the grid background will be the same as the rest of the channel, typically a solid color. But if the Grid Background Poster Opacity parameter is greater than 0, the grid background will be copied from the selected grid poster. The Grid Background Poster Opacity parameter is a percentage from 0 to 100. The larger the value, the more opaque the background image will be. Here is a Grid Background Poster Opacity value of 10. Here is a Grid Background Poster Opacity value of 50. Here is a Grid Background Poster Opacity value of 100. Now we'll put the Grid Background Poster Opacity back to the value of 30. Scroll down to the Grid Description parameter and change it to Top. The original grid description setting of Bubble causes the video description to be shown in a bubble near the selected item. The new grid description of Top causes the video Short Description Line 1 and Short Description Line 2 parameters to appear at the top of the screen. Scroll down to the Grid Focus Border Color parameter and change it to E81010, which is the hex color code for red. Scroll down to the Grid Logo HD parameter, uncheck the PKG checkbox, and enter http://ex.irchan.com/grid/overhang.png. The overhang position can be adjusted by dragging it or by typing in new X and Y positions. The new overhang URL replaces the default Instant TV channel overhang. Scroll down to the Grid Overhang Slice HD parameter and uncheck the Package checkbox. Leave this value blank, it will not be used. Scroll down to the Single Item List Bypass parameter and select True. This allows the channel to jump immediately into the grid instead of requiring the viewer to select a poster to get to the grid. Single Item List Bypass affects any level of the channel that contains a single selection. Now we will add the content to the channel. From the menu along the left side of the page, select Content. This is the Content Editor. It allows you to change the details of individual video or audio content items. It also lets you add new content items and move, copy, or delete existing content items. Notice the Content Editor help shown in the window along the right side of the page. This window often contains useful information about how to use the current parameter. The Content Tree shown in the upper left window is a visual representation of your Roku channel's layout. Each list, grid, or content item is shown here. Clicking any item causes the details of that item to be shown in the lower detail window, and any poster artwork associated with the item is shown in the upper right poster window. Clicking the plus symbol next to a list series grid or grid row expands it to show the content items it contains. Right-click the yellow folder in the content tree and select New Grid. This adds a new grid to the channel. On the bottom half of the page, scroll down to List Style and change Flat Movie to Flat 16x9. This will be the default size of the posters in the grid. Right-click the bottom New Video or Audio item in the content tree and select Delete. This item is not needed. Click on the plus symbol next to the yellow New Grid icon to expand it. Right-click on the yellow New Grid icon in the content tree and select New MRSS or Playlist. Repeat this step two more times so that there are a total of three new MRSS or playlist items under the new grid icon. Left-click on the first new MRSS or playlist item in the content tree. On the bottom half of the page, change the value of Short Description Line 1 to Row 1. Change Grid Row Scale to 2.6. This multiplies the size of the poster displayed in the grid. Scroll down to the poster style parameter and change it to Rounded Rect 16x9 Generic. This is the size of the poster that will be displayed on the springboard screen when the grid item is selected. Left-click on the second new MRSS or playlist item in the content tree. On the bottom half of the page, change the value of Short Description Line 1 to Row 2. Change Grid Row Scale to 1.7. Scroll down to the poster style parameter and change it to Rounded Rect 16x9 Generic. Left-click on the third new MRSS or playlist item in the content tree. On the bottom half of the page, change the value of Short Description Line 1 to Row 3. Leave Grid Row Scale at 1.0. Scroll down to the poster style parameter and change it to Rounded Rect 16x9 Generic. Click on the plus symbol next to the New Grid Row item to expand it. This is a regular row of individual video items. It currently contains a single video item. If you right-click on the row icon, you can add more video items. Click on the row icon again to select it. On the bottom half of the page, change the value of Grid Row Title to Standard Row. Leave Grid Row Scale at 1.0. The final step in building the grid channel is to generate the package file. From the menu along the left side of the page, select Channels. Click on the row containing the channel to be packaged. In the same row as the new channel, there is a package button with a red box around it. Click the package button in the channels row. Click the Confirm Package button at the top of the page. After the channel has been packaged, a Download Package link is displayed. Click on the Download Package link and save the file somewhere on your computer. You will need this file to upload to your Roku Developer account in order to publish the channel. The package file contains the script that will be loaded from Roku servers onto any Roku device that installs your channel. After you upload and publish the package file into your Roku Developer account, your grid channel will be available on your Roku device and should look like this. The first three rows are the MRSS items. The top row has been configured to have larger posters. The bottom row is the original grid row containing a single video. Additional videos can be added to this row to fill it out. Watch the Build a Roku Channel Part 2 video to learn how to upload the package file into your Roku Developer account.